how's it going, everybody? This is Dr. Matt again with ZBT, and welcome back to our performance enhancement video. Today's video is all about sprint mechanics. I've been getting a lot of hamstring strains coming through my door lately, and it's usually due to something wrong going on in the sprinting form, whether it be arms or legs, something's not working right. The weighted sled push is actually going to help resolve that issue. Okay, a couple points of performance we need to talk about. I like to see the arms extended, fully extended and locked out, and actually punching into the handles as opposed to being bent and the handles resting on the chest. This is important because it helps develop the connectivity and the transfer of energy from the feet through the midsection of the torso and up into the hands. This is going to have a great transference over not only to how well we get a good arm swing for our sprint and when we're running, but also if you worry about how it's going to affect your crossfitting, think about a thruster, right? You got to take that front squat from the bottom position of the squat, drive up through the feet, not lose any tension or connection through the midline and put it up in through the arms and into the hands and press it up overhead. Okay. The other point of performance is the legs and the feet, so the lower extremity. What we need to see is with the arms locked out, you get a nice big E drive up towards the chest with the foot actually pulled towards the shin. This is important because it helps develop the most efficient sprinting pattern, whether you're out in the track or out in the field. What we see a lot is that foot turns out and the hip and the leg circumduct. We put a lot of excess stress on your biceps femoris, which is the most commonly torn hamstring. Now, a couple ways I like to progress this. I can load up really heavy for the novice athlete and actually have them perform it slower. It's gonna help develop that pattern. Now, as we get better at it, we can start to layer in speed and start actually sprinting with it. This is gonna help develop the capacity and the volume that'll transfer over not only out into sport, but also out into working out like CrossFit. So I want you guys to get out there and mess around with it. It's not gonna beat you up. There's no essential component to it, so you're not gonna get super sore from it. So you can spend a good deal of time messing with your form and your technique. This is really, really gonna help improve your performance, not only of your sprint, but also of how well you perform in the gym and in sport. Take care, guys.